I'm here with Tom Loeffler, the promoter of Gennady Golovkin. He's also the promoter of the Klitschko's. Excitement in the air. You could feel it here in Manhattan Beach, California. The fight's 48 hours away. Yeah. What goes through your mind right now?
You know, we had such a terrific response on this fight. It's really exciting. I mean, it's so much anticipation. And everyone's looking forward to a great night and all the energy in the crowd at the StubHub. I think it'll be an electric night.
Now, Tom, a fighter like Gennady Golovkin comes along once in a blue moon. How did you end up becoming his promoter?
It was a lot of work. You know, they had interviewed a lot of promoters. His managers, Oleg and Max Herman, had approached a lot of different promoters. And they were committed to coming here to the United States. And it just seemed like it was a good fit. I spoke to him for about 6 months. We went over the deal and what the game plan would be. And seems like it's worked out very well.
It seems like it's coming to fruition, whatever you told us.
Everything I promised.
Look at this press conference, and he has the posters, and he's on HBO.
Everything I promised as far as making him one of the biggest stars in America came true actually a little bit faster than we had anticipated. But, you know, 2 years, I mean, Gennady will do whatever it takes to rise to the top. And now he's considered the best middleweight in the world, and he's one of the biggest stars here, in not only in the U.S., but internationally.
Did you hear what Freddie Roach said today?
What did Freddie say today?
Freddie said that after Canelo, Cotto will go for Triple G.
That's great.
I'm like, why didn't he go for him right now?
Yeah. I mean, that's a big fight. You can't take anything away from either Canelo or Cotto. That's a huge fight. But, you know, Gennady and Cotto at Madison Square Garden would be a huge event. That'd be the biggest event they've had there in a very long time.
I know it's also been in the news lately, Muhammad Ali, they said he has trouble speaking. You had the privilege and the honor to meet him. Can you tell me about that?
Ali is, he is truly the greatest of all time. Not only what he accomplished in the ring, what he did outside the ring, all the social struggles that he went through. And I just have the utmost respect for Muhammad. And I have the privilege of meeting him a number of times. We put together the premiere of his movie, the Will Smith movie, Ali, in Germany. So he flew over there to attend that. And so it's been, you know, every time I have a chance to spend time with him, it's always something special.
I heard he does magic tricks, Tom. Did he do any tricks with you? What does he do exactly?
He hides a handkerchief in his thumb, and, you know, he levitates. He's able to raise off the ground. So he's still an entertainer. He's really
a showman.
Showman, yeah.
What mark does he leave on boxing as the greatest ever?
You know, he accomplished things at that time that were, you know, unheard of in boxing. You know, just what he did in the ring, his movement, his speed, and his power, I think, was underrated. So, and the fact that he was able to market himself, he was really the most recognized person in the world, and he had the true definition of being a world champion. And as I said, the greatest of all time. You know, he fought in Japan, he was in Manila, you know, so many different countries internationally, and that's what raised his profile internationally.
The future of boxing.
He's doing a great job.
Not the future, the present.
The present.
How are you, Tom?
Great.
What do you think of the fight?
Unbelievable. It's one of the real exciting events that whether it lasts one round or 12 rounds, is going to be very explosive.
Not one empty seat. It's so they kept adding seats
standing
every
room.
Week.
It's a standing room.
I hope I get a seat for me.
So last thing, what's the one thing that Gennady has that he doesn't get enough credit for?
His defense.
You don't think he gets credit for
his defense? He gets a lot of credit for his knockouts. He's got 17 knockouts in a row. But if you look at the comparison, if you look at his face out after the fight, he's never really marked up. And he doesn't get hit clean. He's willing to take punches in order to provide for excitement, provide action in the ring. His defense is definitely underrated.
Mauricio, WBC belt on the line, right?
Yes. Very excited, very happy, very proud. Especially Gennady, for years has been expressing his respect and honorability for Mexico. He has Julio Cesar Chavez as his icon. He has Abel Sanchez in his corner. He likes to fight like a Mexican, and this is the first time he fights a Mexican, so this is a very special fight.
They're calling it Mexican style. There you have it. Tune in. It's going to be something. FeliceReport.com and Melissa Quack reporting. Thank